Hi everybody, David Dilling from Markzware, and we get a lot of bad files in here, and a lot of them are big, like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 gigabytes, and I was wondering what's going on here. So did a little research, and basically the problem is people are embedding the links from their images or their graphics. Now, vector graphics, small things, aren't such a big deal if you embed those, even a few images, but if we're talking about 300-400-page documents, even a 50-page document, a lot of images, well, it could be a huge problem, and that's what we're seeing. So when you have, you know, when you add your images in, you know, you can add an image box or drag and drop it, however you want to do it, doesn't really matter. Once you have your image, what people are doing, they're taking an image and they're, you know, going over here, and, you know, we can see where it is down here and all that. It's a linked file, a linked graphic on the links panel here. Now, if you just control click or right click on Windows, you can go embed link. Now, if you do that, you'll see you get this little image here, right? And, you know, we can do that with this one too. We can, you know, embed link, et cetera, et cetera. And if we save this out, it's a bigger document here with some missing images. We save this out now. I drop this file on Flight Check, which is our pre-flight and packaging tool. Standalone checks Illustrator, InDesign, Photoshop, PDFs, Quark, you know, JPEGs, PNGs, you name it, it'll check it. It's a great quality assurance tool to use. And we see all of our fonts here and, you know, image problems, vector resolution out of range, etc. And you see the embedded files went with no name because that's what internally is going to happen if you create a PDF out of this. But we'll see the name down here, and we see it's a, you know, the type of file it was, an image, and here we see a Illustrator EPS, the logo. That's the one we have linked, and that's okay, CMYK. This RGB may or may not be a problem. It's quite a big file, and it's stored, so it's adding a lot of, you know, meat to that file that's not needed. And once again, if you have, you know, hundreds or thousands of these files embedded or stored, as we called it, that's a big problem. So this is a big no-no, because when you go to collect your job, you want to have available these for collection and InDesign. That would be called packaging. And that's basically the quick tip of the day. Do not embed your images if you have a lot of them. You know, if you just have a few, it's not a big deal, right? And then you don't have to be victim of having to use our bad file recovery service, which here you see Flight Check we just showed you for pre-flight and packaging. Here's our file recovery service, which, you know, works 70-75% of the time, maybe even a bit more. It depends, like, it goes to the moon cycles. You never know when it's going to work better or not. But basically, you don't want to have to use this. You don't want to have to fix these files. And a lot of bad files come in, are quite hefty. Well, I'd say it's in the top three. There are bigger problems, and I'll cover those in another video. That's a tip. Don't embed those images. Leave a live link to the file. And by the way, you can unembed images by, once again, control right click on a Mac or just right click and unembed link. And it'll have the link back to the original, back to the original file, right? So that's the way to have a link to your images and not embed with the InDesign file. So David Dilling from Markzware, wishing you a fantastic day, and stay tuned for more tips later.